Yo, holla at your boy. It's your dog, Philadelphia Freeway, a.k.a. Basil, and we holding it down on the Dean Show early. Make sure y'all tune in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, assalamu alaikum, peace be with you. I'm Eddie, your host, and you know what you're watching. You're watching the Dean Show, and when we come back, Jay-Z from the Rockefeller Records, boy, Freeway. And I'm not talking about the freeway you took to get to your home. I'm talking about Freeway the rapper. We want to know, is he happy? He got to live what many call the American dream. You see him on TV, jumping and rapping and dancing, the rock stars, the rap stars, the actors and actresses. Is it all a facade? Do you still want to chase that way? What do you do when you get there? Well, he got there. So what we want to know, is that the right direction to go? When we come back, we're going to help you to find out. So then you can see if you want to continue going that way or you want to change your agenda, change your thinking, change the direction that you're going in life. And before we take a break, I just want to remind you that we have, if you didn't already know, now you know, we have The Dean Show on DVD. 2 discs in one case, professionally, beautifully packaged, so you can share The Dean Show with the world. Share this message of peace with everyone you know. Make sure that after the show, no excuses. It's only $5. $5 for 2 DVDs in one case. And it makes a perfect gift for you to give anybody. That's right. And if you get a box of 50, it goes down to $4. This is just to help cover the cost so we can print more and so we can give more of them out to a lot of our non-Muslim brothers in humanity, that we want them to be our brothers in faith. That's right. And we want them to understand the most misunderstood way of life a little bit better. So do your part. No excuses. After the program, get your DVD today. And we'll be right back with Freeway from Rockefeller Records.
Allah. There's only one God, and Muhammad is his messenger. Allah, la ilaha illallah. Allah, there's only one God, and Jesus was his messenger. Allah, la ilaha illallah.
I don't know why I did that. Maybe it's just to break the ice.
Allah.
Well, Walter said to me, why have you become a Muslim? No, I give a very frivolous answer. I say, I want to be on the side of the angels.
Tupac is a guy. He's the number one rap artist in the world. He sold over 60 million records worldwide.
60 million?
60 million. He was a young guy who had basically everything that some of the youth would think that life is all about. He had everything you can imagine.
The Dean Show.
And we're back here on The Dean Show, and we have with us today from the Rockefeller Records, Jay-Z's homeboy, Freeway. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
How you doing, brother?
I'm good, mashallah.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you.
Wa alaikum salam.
Thank you for being with us here on The Dean Show.
No problem.
Now tell us a little bit about yourself, brother.
I'm one of the artists from the Rockefeller Records. You know, the Dynasty era and all that, you know. Y'all might know me as Freeway. You know, I had a very prosperous career in the music business. You know, I've been with Jay-Z, Beanie Siegel, the whole State Property, Rockefeller family for several years. We put out a lot of hits, made a lot of money.
How long have you been with Mr. Jay-Z?
Since 2000, around 2000, 2001.
Now, is he one of the more famous rappers out there in the hip-hop community?
He's definitely one of the top rappers in the game.
Tell us, how did you get involved in the hip-hop industry?
Since I was younger, I always had a passion for the music. So I was always trying to get on. I was always trying to be a rapper. And it's another rapper out of Philly named Beanie Siegel. He's also Muslim, mashallah. And he got involved with Rockefeller Records, and he pulled me on.
Now tell us, brother, was that the American dream that you wanted as a youth growing up, to be a famous hip-hop rapper?
Definitely an American dream. It's definitely like, in society, it's like a top goal for people. To be famous and to be in the music business is definitely like one of the number one dreams probably for a lot of children.
Now, have you also been on some of the other TV programs such as BET, MTV?
Definitely, I've been BET, MTV, you name it, I've been there.
But it looks like now you're starting to take a turn for the better life, the life that brings peace and tranquility to the hearts. Tell us about this.
Well, actually, I've been Muslim since I was about 15 or 16. So the whole process of me trying to be a musician and trying to be famous, I was Muslim the whole time, but I didn't have the correct dawah. You know, I didn't know that music is not lawful for Muslims. Like, it's something that you shouldn't do. Like, me doing music could do a lot of things. It could take away from the remembrance of Allah for me, and also for people that's listening to my music. While they're listening to my music, they could be studying or reading Quran or anything that could do with the remembrance of Allah.
Now, Islam, which simply means peace acquired by submitting your entire self to the will of the one true Creator, it calls to everything pure, everything good, that original organic goodness. And when you do Islam, you get that peace and happiness. Now, the songs that you were writing, singing, is this something that would you feel bring someone towards that same way that Islam brings a person to, the pure way?
I'm also from the street, so like I try to get people the positive and the negative. I guess that's just a part of my characteristic and the way that I was raised. So like all my music was not like telling people to shoot people and kill people and sell drugs. Like, I'll give you the positive and the negative. Like, I'll give you things that I went through and things that I seen, and I could give you the result of that and what could happen if you don't do it, you know? So I was always trying to be fair with the people with my music.
Now, brother, for our youth out there who have taken yourself and some of the other famous hip-hop artists, rock artists, actors and actresses as role models, what advice do you have for them?
My advice to the people that's trying to pursue the music business, I don't think you should do it. Like, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy, because it takes away from the remembrance of Allah. And once you're in it, you're in it. Like, it's contractual things that keep you bonded and everything. So once you're in it, you're in it.
That's deep. Tell us, why wouldn't you wish that on your worst enemy?
We'll be right back.
It comes to you the truth and the attribute of the one who created you, that he's one and alone running this universe, that he doesn't become born, he doesn't die, he doesn't eat and go to the bathroom. This is not God.
The problem here is,
yeah,
it doesn't make sense. Who was Jesus worshiping? Because it's recorded in the Gospels. Despite all of the other issues about the Gospels, we put those aside, we just say it's mentioned there that Jesus worshiped God.
One who protects us from hunger.
You have to pray as if everything depends on Allah, and it does. But you must work as if everything depends on you, and it doesn't. That's my point. You see what I'm saying, man? And I don't like that. I don't like us sitting here. What are you waiting for? What are we waiting for right now? What are we waiting for all these people to come to Islam? What are we waiting for? What are we waiting for right now? When they're going to come? They're going to come, Allah going to bring these people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in our hand the ability to do it. Now do your job.
Like, because, like, it's a struggle with me. Like, I deal with it every day, you know. I'm Muslim. I pray 5 times a day. I done made umrah 2 times, you know. I pay zakat. I do the things that I'm supposed to do. But on the flip side, I'm stuck in the music business, and I got to do a lot of negative things. Like, I got to do a lot of shows, a lot of traveling. Like, I got to be around a lot of craziness, you know. And it's a struggle for me. And I want my worst enemy to go through it. I want my worst enemy to be Muslim, because that's what's pure and that's what's beautiful. I want everybody to be Muslim because it's beautiful.
Now tell us, learning more about Islam, have you been able to view life differently? Do you know truly what the purpose of life is now? And are you more aware of this transitory life?
Yes, I do. You know, what's funny is I've been knew that, you know, and on one of my raps, I said it, like, I had a song with me, Jay-Z, and Beanie Siegel, and I was like, purpose of man, worship Allah, then you die. Like, that's how I started off my first the verse of it. But the purpose of life is to worship Allah and to make sure your good deeds outweigh your bad deeds so you can make it to Jannah and you don't make it to the hellfire. And Jannah is heaven.
You mentioned something before when we spoke, being nervous while flying. Talk to us about this for a second.
Yeah, because I'll be nervous because, like, the whole thing is to make sure your good deeds outweigh your bad deeds. And I do good deeds, but with the music, it's bad deeds. It's like I told y'all, it's a rhyme, it's unlawful. So Allah knows best, but hopefully when my time comes, when I do die, my good deeds outweigh my bad deeds. But right now, I don't know. So, like, a lot of things I do, I be nervous. Like when I fly, I don't have no control, so I be nervous. Like, you know, I make a lot of dua when I'm in the air, you know what I'm saying? And I just leave it in Allah's hands.
Now, people from the outside looking in, they see the videos, they see the big screen, and they see the hip-hop rappers, the rock stars, the musicians. And in the videos, everyone's having a great time, smiles on the face. And people from the outside are like, wow, this is the life I want to be living. Seems like they're all happy and jipper. Now, do you know something that we don't know? Being in that lifestyle, can you talk to us about this?
Yeah, that's just a persona that we portray. You know, it's a like the brother Amir said, like Loon said yesterday.
On the outside, everything looks good. You see the $100,000 cars, you see a lot of diamonds, you see, you know, for men, for the sake of men, you see a lot of females, and they think that this is, you know, this is the life. This is like, you know, paradise right here on earth. But the reality of it is, you know, I couldn't purchase peace.
Like, it's like 3 minutes and 40 seconds out of a whole day that you see. And we're supposed to make you think that everything is all right. But the reality is, a lot of people that's in the music business might have a lot of money and everything, but they're not happy.
We try to forge this character that's, you know saying, like, suitable for the fan. The fan admires this character.
Like, look at Michael Jackson. You see all the things that he was going to do, like it's coming out now, all the medicine and stuff that he was taking just to be calm and be regular. Like, it's a lot of stress. People don't even know.
Now, have you had a chance to sit with some of the other famous rappers, rockers, actresses, and have you had a chance to share this truth with them?
A lot of people are searching for peace, like, and they don't know where to find it at, you know? So it's like my job and some of the other brothers, like the brother Amir, like, That's one of the goals that we're setting. That's why we're studying so much and we're trying to build up enough knowledge so we can approach the people and let them know that Islam will bring you peace. Like, it's beautiful.
Now tell us, brother, people want to know, are you trying to get out of the music industry?
Yeah, definitely. Like, that's definitely one of my goals, you know. I definitely want to get out the music industry and raise my family, be a strong Muslim, and be a good example for a lot of people, you know.
So they have you locked in with a contract?
Yeah.
Now tell us, what's Islam? What does Islam encourage a human being to do? And what's this way of life encourage a person to do?
Islam encourages you to be peaceful. It encourages you to have good, like, Muslims have good characteristics. Like, when you see a Muslim, you know that that's a Muslim just by the way that they carry themselves, their mannerisms. Like, you know, share with people. You know, if I got a dollar and my brother needs 50 cents, he can have it all day, you know? It's like, it's just beautiful. Like, Muslims, you could tell that they have good hearts, you know? And the music business brings arrogance because you got a lot of fans, you know, a lot of people who look up to you and love your music, so of course that'll put you on a high horse and have you thinking that you're doing something, and it's not you, it's Allah that gives you anything. Muslim or non-Muslim, like, if you're rich, Allah gave that to you. It don't matter if you're Muslim or not, you know? And it's also like the women, fornication, you know, women throwing themselves at you all the time, everywhere you go, as soon as you leave out the house. And it's crazy, it's a lot of madness. When I first got famous in a it was exciting, you know? If you come from the streets like me, I'm from the hood, like, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of hood people be trying to be on the low. Like, you don't even want a lot of people paying you no attention. And then all of a sudden, you're getting a lot of attention from everywhere, you know? It's, of course, it's going to be exciting at first, but...
Tell us, brother, has it been a challenge getting yourself together like you're starting to do and leaving off following your passions and desires as many others are?
Definitely was a challenge. It definitely was a challenge. Like, it took several years for me to get myself together and get level-headed and grounded.
Now, what advice for the men do you have? It's a big test. It's a big trial nowadays. And for those men who just can't stop chasing the women one after another, following their lusts and desires, they can't settle down. And you know what? They're like a stray dog with cologne all over the place. What advice do you have for them?
You know, that's one of the natural things that men go through, like with the women. You know, that's why all men should be married. I think that definitely. So, like, if you read, it lets you know, like, that's half of your deen. You know, being married, that's half of your deen. So, if it's that serious, it should let you know right there.
Now we know that the men like to chase and the women like to flaunt. What advice do you have for the sisters, those who love the attention but aren't paying attention to the boundaries of the creator of the heavens and the earth? So they end up taking the examples of some of the worst, some of the actresses and actors, and they end up listening more to the advice of Britney Spears and the J-Lo's. What advice do you have for those sisters?
Definitely need to get themselves together in fair love, because it's going to lead to the hellfire.
Have you had a chance to share Islam with Jay-Z?
Definitely, we had a few conversations about Islam. He's not really like, inshallah, you know what I'm saying? Inshallah, some more talks. We might be able to pull a brother in, you know. But Allah makes Muslims, like, I could talk to my face turn blue, but if Allah doesn't want somebody to be Muslim, they're not going to be Muslim.
Now, what advice do you have for our sisters who we love? We love our sisters and we want the best for them. So we want to give them some advice so they don't get played or played out.
I think they should realize the power that they have, and they need to get themselves together and stay focused and find themselves a nice husband and raise a family.
Now tell us, do men really respect women who just throw themselves at some of the famous entertainers?
We'll be right back.
It comes to you the truth and the attribute of the one who created you, that he's one and alone running this universe, that he doesn't become born, he doesn't die, he doesn't eat and go to the bathroom. This is not God.
You got problems here.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense.
Who was Jesus worshiping?
Because it's recorded in the Gospels. Despite all of the other issues about the Gospels, we put those aside. We just say it's mentioned there that Jesus worshiped
God.
One who protects us from hunger.
I don't think no man would respect a woman that would just throw themselves at him and just sleep with him just because they see him on TV. Like, how could you have respect for a woman like that? Would you want somebody like that to be the mother of your children? No.
Now, brother, give us and our viewers some closing comments and advice to those people who epitomize this lifestyle, are trying to live this lifestyle, are in this lifestyle.
My advice is to stay away from the music, you know. The remembrance of Allah is the best thing. The best speech is the speech of Allah. And that's where it's at right there, you know what I'm saying? This music is nothing, you know. And it's no good for you. You get no positive results from it. The best speech is the speech of Allah.
Please define these Arabic words that you just used, brother.
Allah is God. There's nothing worthy of worship. No deity, nothing on this planet, nothing anywhere worthy of worship but Allah. He's the ultimate creator. He has no partners, and that's who we worship.
قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
Thank you, brother, for being with us on The Deen Show. May Allah, the creator of the heavens and earth, reward you. Assalamu alaikum, peace be with you.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
And that was our brother, and we want to make sincere, I'm talking about sincere supplication, dua for him. He has done what many in that position find it very, very difficult to do, even to ponder and think about the more serious questions in life. Why? Because they're distracted. Too much fun and play, too much money, too much bling bling. But he has taken the first step, and he acknowledged that what he's doing, the way he's headed, is the wrong direction, and he's trying to get out. So we pray that the creator of the heavens, of the earth, Allah, the Almighty, makes it easy for him. And God willing, next time we see him, inshallah, he'll be totally out of this business. And we also hope that you gotten to really benefit from his advice, from his story, from people looking from the outside. We got to talk to someone in the inside. So if you also are chasing that American dream, or what you think is the American dream, that I want to be famous, I want to reach for the stars, I want to be a star. No, that's the wrong way to go. He's telling you, and many others who are in that life, but they're just miserable. They don't have peace. They have money, but money can't buy peace and happiness. The only way you can get true peace and happiness is to acquire it by submitting yourself totally and humbly to the one who created you. He has sent the best examples throughout time, and these were the messengers. These were the men to be followed. They were the guides. They were the ones giving us the formula how we can be successful in this life and the hereafter. And know that this life is short. It can end at any time. It's a test, so we want to pass. And we don't want to be distracted, because all the entertainment out there, all the music and the movies and all these other things that really call a person in the wrong direction. So you want to go in the right direction, the direction that God Almighty wants you to go towards. And that's the way that you can be successful and you can be in a reality. Because when you go and turn up the music and you fill your head and you fill your life with all of this junk, what's going to be produced? Junk. But when you fill your heart, your mind, yourself with the remembrance of the one who created you, then that can only produce good. That can only produce good. And then there'll be a good outcome. And then when the angel of death comes to take your soul, you've been ready, you've been prepared. Then you can pass the test. And then you can be successful also in the next life, in paradise. That's what we're all striving for paradise. So if this is the first time that you've tuned on to the Dean Show, do what we always humbly ask you to do. Ask the one who created you, the one who gave you life, him alone. Don't ask the stars, don't ask the sun, don't ask a man or a woman. Ask the one who created man and woman, but he's not a man or woman. Ask the one who created the sun and the moon. Ask him alone to guide you, to make things clear. That is the first step. And then be courageous enough to follow the truth up with action. Come back here every week on The Dean Show. Don't forget now to get The Dean Show on DVD. Also, you can get our new audio shows, the radio show, at thedeenshow.com blog section. You can download it for your iTunes, for your iPods. It's all free. The DVD is only $5. That's it, only $5. If you get 50, it goes down to 4. And if you get more, we can make it even less. So make sure that you guys are filling your cars and your TVs with good material and staying away from all this junk. I call it pollution. Breathing good air, putting good things into your body and mind. Fill it with Quran, fill it with the remembrance of the one who created you. And that is how you can live a good, wholesome life. And we'll see you next time, God willing, here on The Dean Show. Until then, peace be unto you.
No speech is better than to do da'wah, to call people to Allah and to do the work.
No speech is better.
No, nothing is better than that.
Is it true that if one person on the Allah giving you the ability to guide someone with Allah's permission, the Creator's permission, that is better than everything in this world?
Better than the whole world and everything that's in it. In another narration, it's better than the best of wealth. But if we really felt that, Eddie, would we not be out giving da'wah?
And this is something that we encourage all the MSAs, all the da'wah organizations, the masjids, to get this. We want to print more. We give these to the non-Muslims for free, for free, for free. We want our brothers in humanity to become our brothers in faith.
It's cold, it's late, everybody's sleeping. I arise and ask Allah to forgive me. Oh Allah, you see, oh Allah, you know, all the sins I do. I turn to you to forgive my sins and my heart. I'm your sinful slave, you're my loving Lord. I'm the one who runs away, oh Allah, guide me.